Before proceeding to the topic, test your knowledge of the topic. A 47-year-old man who is a worker on demolition sites comes to you for review. He is having increasing tiredness, lethargy, headache, and abdominal pains over the past 3 months. On examination, he is hypertensive with a blood pressure of 160 over 90 mm of mercury, he has a regular pulse of 82 beats per minute, and he looks pale. Investigations are done which show a hemoglobin of 9.7 gram per deciliter with 78 femtoliter MCV, platelets of 175,000 per microliter, and white cells 6,000 per microliter. Lead level is measured which is 100 microgram per deciliter. Peripheral blood film reveals basophilic stippling. Given the possible diagnosis, which of the following is the most appropriate initial intervention? Disodium EDTA, dimercaptosuccinic acid, hemodialysis, activated charcoal, or deferciox? Right answer is dimercaptosuccinic acid, or DMSA. The diagnosis here is lead poisoning, and DMSA is an oral chelation therapy that can be used for chronic lead poisoning. 500 mg twice per day is a usual initial therapeutic dose. A lead level above 70 microgram per deciliter indicates significant occupational exposure and that the patient should be withdrawn from work. Disodium EDTA is used in the management of acute lead poisoning and is given intravenously. Given his lead exposure represents chronic exposure, there is no role for activated charcoal. Deferciox is used for iron overload, and there is no role for hemodialysis in chronic lead poisoning. In questions, giving a combination of abdominal pain and neurological signs, along with acute intermittent porphyria, a diagnosis of lead poisoning should be considered. Lead poisoning occurs usually in chronic occupational exposure, as seen in question at the beginning of this video. Or with leaded paint, water contaminated by lead pipes, and with use of coal cosmetics. Lead poisoning affects many organs, including liver, kidneys, nervous system, bone, teeth, and heme. It is directly toxic to cell membranes through production of free radicals. It also interferes with DNA transcription, enzymes involved in different cell processes, and NMDA receptors in nervous system. Most characteristic is defective ALA dehydratase and ferrochelatase function during heme synthesis. Resultantly, there is development of anemia. Another effect of lead's interference with heme synthesis is the buildup of heme precursors, such as aminolevulinic acid, which may be directly or indirectly harmful to neurons. Elevation of aminolevulinic acid results in lead poisoning having symptoms similar to acute porphyria. Features include fatigue, abdominal pain, headache and encephalopathy, peripheral, mainly motor neuropathy, nephrotoxicity, constipation. Blue lines on gum margin, which are observed only in 20% of adult patients and are very rare in children. Hypertension, microcytic anemia with basophilic stippling, and hypocalcemia. Investigations. The blood lead level is usually used for diagnosis. Levels greater than 10 micrograms per deciliter are considered significant. Full blood count will reveal microcytic anemia. Blood film shows red cell abnormalities, including basophilic stippling and cloverleaf morphology. Renal, liver function tests and serum calcium levels shall also be tested. Raised serum and urine levels of delta aminolevulinic acid may be seen, making it sometimes difficult to differentiate from acute intermittent porphyria. Urinary coproporphyrin is also increased. Urinary porphobilinogen and uroporphyrin levels are, however, normal to slightly increased. Although X-rays are not part of the standard workup, in children, lead can accumulate in the metaphysis of the bones. Management of lead poisoning. It includes prevention of further exposure. Lead poisoning is treated with various chelating agents. Those that are currently used include dimercaptosuccinic acid, or DMSA, D-penicillamine, EDTA in acute cases, and dimercaprol. And this is it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please provide your feedback in comments. Like this video, share with other colleagues, and consider subscribing to this channel to get notifications about latest videos.